Hi, everyone. I hope you are well. Today, we're going to be discussing crowdfunding. And with me is the one and only Hannah Forbes. She is the founder and CEO of The Funding Crowd, which is a company that helps fintechs to crowdfund. She has a 100% success rate. So well done, you, Hannah. And in 2020, she has been named the top 100 women in fintech by FinTech Magazine. So welcome. How are you today, Hannah?
I'm good, thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
It's my absolute pleasure. Hannah, so since you are the guru of crowdfunding, and I am the one who's passionate about ESG, can you tell me how important is, if I'm a company and about to crowdfund, how important is it for me to highlight my environmental, my social impact, and my governance strategies before I crowdfund?
It is very important, as I expect was the answer that you were hoping for. So it's absolutely very important, and it's something that has become increasingly more important in crowdfunding. So if you look at the platforms, both Crowdcube and Seeders, the biggest equity crowdfunding platforms in the UK, the vast majority of those pitches will be advertising one of those three letters in quite a significant way. And if it's not fundamentally part of their value proposition, which is a smaller proportion of those people raising, then they'll be talking about it in their pitch or on their discussion forums, or people will be asking them questions about it. So absolutely, it's very important. I would say particularly environmental is one that really resonates with crowd investors. And I recently, I've got a campaign that's live at the moment, and we've been getting regular questions, you know, tell me about your sustainable packaging. Tell me about how you're more responsible with your packaging and the environment. So it's absolutely incredibly important. And it's often something that I would encourage businesses to lead with. The reason it's so important is because making an investment in an early stage startup through crowdfunding is risky. So investors want to know that A, they're putting their money in a company that has good values, but also in the most likely event that they never get a return from their investment, they want to know that at least that money has done some good. So absolutely, it's incredibly important. And all the campaigns I have live at the moment have some aspect of ESG very much at the forefront of their campaign.
And from your experience, the ones who did highlight it so much, were they successful?
Yes.
Do you think they were more successful than the ones who didn't?
Yeah, absolutely. So a good example actually is a campaign that's live at the moment called Tread, and they're the UK's first green debit card. And their card is recycled plastic, and their whole mission is to allow people to spend more sustainably. So every time you spend with Tread, you understand the carbon footprint of what you've just purchased. So if you go to a coffee and you don't use a reusable cup, then you'll get a statement, you know, this is how much CO2 you've emitted by buying this coffee. And that campaign has been hugely successful. They hit their target within 90 minutes, and people are still coming through really quickly. Another campaign that I worked on, Hydro Wind Energy, it's all about big technology to support the fight against climate change. And yeah, hugely successful, really high number of investors. I think they got the second highest number of investors ever on Seeders or something like that. So any companies that have it very, any aspect to do with the environment, social governance at the forefront of their pitch have, in my experience, always done very well. Of course, and this is what you're an expert in, Jihan, you do have to frame it in the right way. It definitely can't be an afterthought. It has to be really embedded neatly in your communication throughout your whole campaign, and not just on your pitch, but in your socials as well. But if it's done right, then I'm very confident that it increases your chance of success.
So this is music to my ears. This is absolutely music to my ears, because I was doing an analysis as well, but from a communications point of view. And last year, one of the top fintech was Chip. And I did an analysis of how they communicated their crowdfunding process since 2017 until now, because they did, I think, two rounds or three rounds of crowdfunding. And it was interesting because the way they pitched at the beginning in 2017, they focused on emotions. When they invited the founder's grandmother to come and be part of the pitch. So they were focused on the emotions part. And then moving to last year, when they did it, it was all about purpose It was all about employees and how proud they were. And to me, in my mind, crowdfunding, it's a one chance. You need to get it right and you need to be super prepared and not depend on the investors within the crowdfunding platform, but instead work at least minimum 6 months to do your marketing, get your marketing right, get the channels right. And by channels, I mean, if your investors are in a specific channel, let's say LinkedIn, for example, focus on that. Don't just focus on another, on different channels. Don't waste your time. Focus on the emotions, focus on the purpose, and not, and most importantly, focus on how the investors will play a role in growing your business. Because by crowdfunding, you are basically demonstrating your commitment to your product and purpose. You are opening a whole new world of new customers and new advocates. And I know that firsthand. I'm an investor in three startups at the moment. And I have been shouting nonstop. They never asked me to shout, but I have been advertising them all over the place. Imagine if you do that and you get the right people in, that would be excellent. So my advice is prepare 6 months in advance by getting the word out, you focusing on the channels where the right investors that you're looking for will be in. Focus on the messages, start with emotions, go into the role they play, and go into where you see the company going and also focus on your employees. Because believe it or not, your employees are your biggest advocates. Even if you have 15 people, these 15 people would be on average, what, 300 people in their networks? That's still not bad. So that is my advice on how would you communicate crowdfunding. And Hannah, if anyone would like to get in touch with you, is LinkedIn the best channel for you?
Yeah, absolutely. So LinkedIn, I'm definitely most active on, but I also have a personal website as well that you can visit for some crowdfunding tips, which is hannahforbes.co.uk.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for today. That's been enlightening. I hope our tips on how to communicate and tips on why you should be showcasing your ESG has been beneficial. If you would like to have more information, you have Hannah on her website on LinkedIn. You have me as well on LinkedIn. And my website, which is comunique.global. Take care, everyone. Bye.